The election of 1800. The Federalist president lost the election, and the Federalist Congress lost their majority. Before the Democratic Republicans took office, though, the Federalists had just a little bit of time. So, what could they do? Well, since the Federalist Party was losing control over both executive and legislative branches of government, they decided to at least give themselves control over the third branch, the judicial. Adams, the president, did this by appointing several judges to shiny new positions in Washington, D.C. The Federalist Congress, of course, approved these appointments. By the time the new presidential administration took over, everything was good to go, except for the commissions. Pieces of paper stating that each judge was officially approved to start their job. These papers were signed and sealed and were left to the Secretary of State. James Madison, the new Secretary of State, was told by the new President Jefferson not to deliver these commissions. This meant that the judges would be delayed in starting until Madison got around to giving the papers out. And how likely do you think one political party is to do this favor for another? A lawsuit followed. William Marbury, one of the judges who was waiting to start his job, brought Madison to court over his refusal to deliver the letters. And not just any court, the Supreme Court of the United States. This court case was one of the first for Federalist Judge John Marshall. And when ruling on this case, he faced a bit of a dilemma. He could order Madison to deliver the commissions, but there's no guarantee that Madison would follow that order. If he didn't, the Supreme Court would be humiliated and likely wouldn't hold even a fraction of the power that it has today. And yet, the opposite decision would mean that the Democratic Republicans successfully stop all the Federalist judge appointments. So, what could he do? Although this case was brought up in early 1801, the ruling was delayed until 1803. During this delay, the judges had a lot of time to think about their decision, and it paid off. Marshall ruled first that Marbury had a right to receive his commission. However, that ruling was irrelevant because the Supreme Court did not have jurisdiction to rule on this case. Let me explain. The Judiciary Act of 1789, passed by Congress, in Section 13 stated that the Supreme Court had the right to issue writs of mandamus. That's a fancy way of referring to the type of court order that they would have to give Madison in order to make him deliver the commissions. Marshall stated that Section 13 went against Article 3, Section 2 of the Constitution, which gave the court the power to issue such writs to states or foreign representatives, or in appellate cases. Madison was not a state, nor was he an ambassador, nor was this case heard in a smaller court before being brought to the Supreme Court. Therefore, the Constitution did not explicitly grant the Supreme Court the right to rule here. Since the Act of 1789 did grant that right to the Supreme Court, Marshall called that act unconstitutional and revoked it. It may seem like this handed a victory to the Democratic Republicans, and it did, but this victory was small compared to the much longer-lasting triumph that the court had for itself. You see, the nation was still pretty new, and the court didn't explicitly have the power to challenge an act of Congress, yet. This ruling, however, in its being accepted, set the precedent that the Supreme Court could decide if a law passed by Congress was unconstitutional, and revoke it if it was, even if the law was signed by George Washington himself, as was the Act of 1789. This was the birth of the court's most powerful function, judicial review. I mentioned the case Hilton v. U.S. a few videos back, and that case also implied the court had the same power that I'm talking about here. The difference was that in that case, the court was taking the side of Congress and upholding the law. This was the first time the court successfully made a law void because it contradicted the Constitution. That gave it a lot more significance than Hilton v. U.S., and that's why Marbury v. Madison is a much better known case.